We've all been there. You open the faucet to pour a beer and nothing comes out. Well, you get too much foam. You can quickly tell when something isn't right with your beer tap and it's time for a little troubleshooting. There are 5 easy checks that you can use to quickly identify the problem and get the beer flowing as fast as possible. The first check is to see if there's beer in the keg. Pick it up and shake it. If it's empty, tap a new keg using the oldest keg first. You can do this by checking the sell date on the keg. Next, if the keg has beer in it, check to make sure the keg is actually tapped. If the coupler lever is pointing up, pull the handle out, push down, and lock it in to tap the keg. The next check is to see if the gas source is turned on. Today's systems use either straight CO2 or a blend of CO2 and nitrogen, N2. Make sure the valve and toggle switches are both on. If they aren't, make sure the CO2 and N2 valves are all the way on and ensure the toggle switch is in the open position. The direction of the toggle switch is lined up with or parallel to the CO2 N2 line. If the tank is on and the switch is in the right position, your next check is to make sure there is CO2 or N2 in the supply tank. Check the high pressure gauge on the tank. If it's at 0, you're out of gas. Proceed with changing the tank and make sure to open the valve and toggle switch as we showed you earlier. Your final check is to make sure the foam control device, or FOB, was reset after the last keg was emptied. If it wasn't, we'll stop the flow of beer. If it wasn't reset, follow your manufacturer's instructions on how to reset it. Since there are a variety of different FOBs out there, we'll be showing you just one example of how to reset an FOB. After verifying the keg is already tapped, push the vent button on the top of the unit to the left or the right until the chamber fills with beer. This will release the gas pressure from inside the FOB. Next, turn the lever on the bottom of the unit up until it stops to release the float and restart the flow of beer. Check the faucet to make sure beer is flowing correctly. If you're still having issues and beer is not flowing, contact your distributor for a troubleshooting call. They will send a draft system expert to help you. If the issue is foamy beer, make sure that your beer is being stored between 36 and 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Kegs should have been in the cooler for at least 24 hours prior to tapping to ensure it is at proper pouring temperature. Also, check to make sure you're using beer clean glasses that are either room temperature or chilled, not frozen. Frozen glasses can cause foaming issues. So there you have it. A few tips to troubleshooting draft system problems. Use them to identify and fix issues faster and keep your customers happy. Remember these steps and you can keep the beer flowing.